And then on the other hand, I was in a relationship that I'd been in for like a year and really loved this person and thought for a long time that I was going to marry this person. And so I just poured a lot of myself into that relationship and just loved on that person very much. So that was also in my mind, like, this is my future, and I could kind of see where my future was going. I'm going to marry this person, I'm going to have this job, I'm going to get this nice house, and this is what it's all going to look like. And I had it kind of planned out in my mind. Well, what I didn't realize is that I also relied a lot on my own plans, and I liked to kind of control my life in that way. And so God, who is so good and so much wiser than we are, was good in my life to act by taking all of that away. So he, when I graduated, all of these things that I thought were part of my future kind of fell apart. And I didn't get that job. And within that year after I graduated, the relationship, you know, wasn't going well. And my eyes were opened a lot to certain things in the relationship that were really unhealthy, that before I didn't really want to look at because I was holding on to that, and I wanted to love that person, and I was controlling that area of my life. And it started, you know, I was really starting to see how unhealthy it was for me, and the relationship started falling apart. So I didn't have the job. I eventually broke up with this man, and so I didn't have that relationship. And I ended up moving home for a year with my parents as well, which in California, in the States, that's not, at that time, that's not something that young adults would really do. Like, after you graduate university, you kind of move on. You get your own place with friends or by yourself. You don't usually go back home. But just the way things turned out, against my own will, God took me home. And it was really a hard time in my life, but it was so good for him to just take all of those things away, because he just broke me down and humbled me so that I could see him. Because before that, I couldn't really see him. And even though I grew up in a Christian home, and I thought I loved God, I did love God as much as I knew how. And I had a relationship with him as much as I knew how. But when he took me through this particular time in my life, where he got rid of all of these things, my eyes were just opened up even more to who he was. And my relationship with him just kind of exploded from there. And it really grew, and my love for him became so much deeper, because when I was at my lowest point, I saw how much mercy and grace he was giving me, and how much love he was really giving me. Because you can't really see that when you're doing it on your own, and you don't think you need God. But when he takes you to a point where you can't do it anymore, and you feel like you're a failure, and what have you done to show God that you love him and that you're deserving of his love? You kind of get to that point, and he says, no, like, you actually aren't deserving. You can't do anything to earn my love or my grace or my favor. I'm just giving it to you. And so that's not something I'd ever seen, because, like I said, I was just very much kind of in control of my life and found a lot of my identity in achieving things and in that success. And so I sort of had this warped view on being a Christian and on who God was. And I thought that the better Christian that I was, the more he would love me. And so it was so impactful for me to understand that he loves me the same no matter what. So at my lowest low, he still loved me the same. And he is the one who chose me. I didn't choose him. He came and chose me. And he gave me faith, and he opened my eyes to who he was. And that just made my love for him just grow even more. So the things that I learned, I think two of the main things that I learned about God during that time were that, one, that he is sovereign, and two, that he is everything, like literally everything. So I just wanted to read a few verses for you guys that kind of illustrate these two points. The first one you may have heard before, it's pretty famous. It's in Jeremiah, chapter 29, verse 11. It says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope. Then you will call upon me and come and pray to me, and I will hear you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart. I love this verse just because it reminds me that God has a plan for my life. And he doesn't promise me knowledge of the future. God never promises that to us in the Bible, that we can know exactly what he's going to do in the future. But he does promise us wisdom along the way. So we just have to trust that he does have that plan, and that he is a good God, and that his plan is good. And along the way, with each step, he gives us wisdom to know what is the right choice and what is the right thing to say and do. And as we go about life, he's guiding our steps along the way. Along with that, one of my favorite passages in the Bible that I just come to again and again in life is Psalm 139. I'm just going to read most of it, so it might take a minute, but it's definitely worth it because it's a beautiful psalm that illustrates who God is to us. So Psalm 139, O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from afar. You search out my path and my lying down and are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, behold, O Lord, you know it altogether. You hem me in behind and before and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high. I cannot attain it. Where shall I go from your spirit, or where shall I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, and the light about me be night, even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is bright as the day, for darkness is as light with you. For you formed my inward parts, you knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, my soul knows it very well. My